Okay, here we are. Now, I found an astrologer on the internet, and she gave a free reading through the email. She just wanted to know all the vital information, birth date, place of birth, and all that stuff. And so I gave it to her, and she sent an email back, and she gave me a little bit of a review, but she wanted to do a deeper review. And of course she wanted money. And so, but I just went ahead, stuck with her small review, and she gave the coordinates of all the planets of my birth in a small review. Basically her review said that I'm spoiled. And so I started, my emotions started feeling depressed and in a vacuum, and there was another word that I wanted to use, but, so I was sitting there in my feelings, I'm thinking, So I'm sitting there soaking in the feelings of depression. And all of a sudden I get the nice idea to go on the internet and look up the word spoiled. So I started doing that. My email reading. So I look up the word spoiled, and so here was the definition of spoiled. Put the picture down here. Okay, a spoiled child, aka spoiled brat. Now, she didn't say, there were good things on the review also, too. But this is the one that stood out to me. And remember, the point of my video is that it put me in an emotion of depression. It's that vacuum feeling. And that's just another way of saying I didn't feel very good about that comment. So I was sitting there doing the feeling, and of course that caused me to finally, after about 10 minutes of feeling the feeling, I looked up the word, and here it says, spoiled child, spoiled brat. In a derogatory way, is a child or adolescent that exhibits behavioral problems from overindulgence by his or her parents. Children and teens who are perceived as spoiled may be described as overindulged, grandiose, narcissistic, or egocentric regressed. So, we're going to have to do this. Move this over like that so we can watch the movie. So, okay, so this word right here, overindulged, or indulged, this is the word that stood out to me, because, let's turn that music down. Because on the free astrological review that I posted on a video on YouTube, I noticed one of the words was, I had to be careful of indulgence. So I looked up the word indulge. And as you can notice here, as I was looking up each word, I came up with the idea to number everything. But I didn't do that until I got down here to actually, let's take this and slide it over. There we go. That way we can read things a little easier. Okay. Whoops. Okay. So I didn't put that there until I started getting down here to partial order, total order. I think he's sliding over, so let's do this. See if we can fix that. We wanted to go that way because it... going to be able to fix that for now. So let's just put it back there. Let's put the music on loop. So down here around partial order, that's when I decided, got the idea for the first time, start numbering these things. However, so I looked up the word indulge, because that's where we're at up here in the blue. Indulgence. So I looked up the word indulge. And keep in mind, as I'm doing this, I'm keeping myself feeling good as I'm reading this stuff. So I'm not wanting to do a whole lot of heavy reading. I'm just looking for the quick, easy impression that these pages are going to give me. So I looked it up. Okay, so here's the one that caught my eye. To yield to an inclination or desire. And as soon as I saw that, all of a sudden my depression lowered. Because I thought, oh, desire. Law of attraction. To give in to our desires. And then I realized, oh yeah. Everything that comes our way is a test of Mother Nature. So, the feeling of depression was a test. A test for me. Not only was it a test for me, but it was a test on my awareness, on the origin of the test, the source of the test. And of course, the source of the test, once I came to my senses, is Mother Nature, with all the backing of Father Cause. So, and then I scrolled it down a little bit further. Oh, I know what I want to do. Because as I'm doing this, you see, I'm building a program for the university that we're going to build. Just in case you didn't know, I have plans to build a university on the earth for learning the knowledge of private maritime law, the law of nature, and the law of the universe, universal law, natural law, and spiritual law. So, what I'm going to do, and you know me, I like to do everything right now in the present moment. And so, as we're doing this video, I'm also building material for the university. There we go. That's what I wanted it to do. indulge. So there we are. So I'm going to make a quick snapshot of this. Save it. Desire. And then we're going to store it. Russell Zodiac, email free reading, words defined, indulge. So there it goes. All right, there it is. So what I'm doing is I'm creating a PowerPoint presentation. And the picture came out pretty good. So there we can see the word indulge with the quick snapshot that the universe was easily bringing to my mind. Okay, good. Now, let's go down here. So here's another one. To satisfy or gratify desires, feelings. Let's get a picture of that one. Gratify feelings. Okay. Double check, make sure it came out. To yield, to satisfy or gratify desires, feelings. There we go. Wonder how I got that thing to slide over last time. Oh well. And then I came across this one. Now keep in mind that I'm doing all this by instinct and impulse. I'm looking for what the universe is revealing to me. And that's all based on the law of attraction. And that's based on following what feels good. So, because when I read the email, I didn't feel very good. So, I had to figure out how I was going to deal with that emotion. Okay, so this is commerce. Hold on. Commerce grant extension of time for payment of performance. Okay. Commerce grant time for payment. Okay. That's what I want. Commerce grant time for payment. Okay. There it is. It came out good. So as we can see in Commerce, to grant extension of time for payment. So I'm thinking of making another folder because I just had a new thought. Let's see what it does. Okay, my thought was Universe grants. Universe grants the time. The reason I'm putting that in there is because I had a contrasting thought that said the corporation grants the time, but with the commercial lien, we take all the power out of the hands of the corporation and put it into our hands, and we put it up to universal law to decide when the time for payment will come. So, just a little bit of thing on that. All right. So I need to line this up. We're going to put a co on there so that it goes underneath the commerce one. You can see. There we go. There we are. So that I've just made myself a mental note on digital format. Alright. Grant time for payments. Okay. So this note right here is the same website. Same website as that one. Nice, Peepy. Peepy? How nice to sit you, Peepy. Uh-oh, he's on his peepy bed. I want his peepy bed. Peepy bed! Let's check this one. Might be the same website. perfect mix of brains and brawn. So that right there is a universal message to me. Personal message from the universe to me. Overindulge. Looking to see if there's something on here. Okay, indulge food or drink. Ah, so here it is, right here. This one caught my mind. Let's get a picture of that one. Let's see what it said. Transitive. Yield to wishes. Okay. Yield to wishes. Let's check it. So there it is. Get rid of that one. Okay, so that's a good one. Notice it says transitive, yield excessively to wishes. Okay, that would be like, yeah, I want my desires fulfilled, you know, as much as possible to the excess, as much as possible. Okay, let's see if there's something. So you can see, as I'm doing my search for defining words, creating my own reality, I'm creating my own reality by creating my own neural pathways, because what we have up here in the brain is we have a big giant hard drive of unstored space that we can store information on. And those are called neural pathways. So what I'm doing is I'm creating new neural pathways in my hard drive that's right here. The skull, between the skull. So as I'm doing all this, I'm creating new pathways. And the more we repeat and go over and over and practice and look at the definitions over and over, speak them in our minds over and over, the stronger those neural pathways become. Okay, so that was all there was on that one. Transitive. Transit. Just looking over. Okay, so I'm ignoring all this right here, which puts thoughts in my mind of overeating, binging, over drugging, over fooding, over sexing, over whatever. And I'm not wanting to focus on negative things. Things that are going to make me feel depressed. Although, there is a necessity sometimes to embrace those feelings. But that all has to do with shadow work. There is a time to embrace so that we can see what's on the other side of the fence. But once we've seen what's on the other side of the fence, we realize, oh, well, I want to be balanced and have a balance of what's on the good side and what's on the bad side. But for the time being, I'm wanting to, right now, polarize my feelings of depression and gravity from reading of the email that said I was spoiled. And my ego animal brain is the one that's responsible for taking us into depression. That sinking feeling. That feeling that doesn't feel good. You know how it feels when someone in the past has made fun of us, called us a name. You know, we felt belittled. It's all the same feeling. So, what I'm doing is a tool that I developed called launching my Polaris missile. And so I'm quickly polarizing all the way to the other side of feeling good so that I can feel good. Because that Polaris missile is a rehabilitation device. The Polaris missiles that I developed are rehabilitation missiles. They're not the popular destructive missiles, like Polaris missiles that are being shot from nuclear submarines, Trident submarines and stuff like that. So, but polarizing is a tool that I developed for the courses that I'm going to, or that we are going to teach on the Earth. Because, you know, we are all in this together, so we are all going to develop this universal college. And basically, for the most part, it's an online university. So, it's... But, we can also use the universities that are already in place to, to have a physical building for assembly where people can assemble together in. So, alright, so that's that. the next word that I was wanting to look up was grandiose, because grandiose was one of the words that showed up here in the spoiled. So let's take a look at the spoiled. Oh, there it is. Okay, so I don't have to stretch this out. We can see that it says spoiled, shielded from frustration. This one's spoiled, shielded from expression. Okay, so these are notes that I've made. And this one says spoiled to destroy value. Because these were words that were so you can see here it says spoiled to destroy the value of. Now keep in mind I'm thinking commercially now, because that's the world that we live in. We live in a world of private maritime law that has to deal with commerce. And the corporation, or let's actually start from the source. Father Cause and Mother Nature has set up on purpose and put the corporation in place to teach us, to teach mankind how to be peaceful, safe, and self-responsible without the need of a nanny, without the need of the corporate nanny, due to the fact that we were killing each other in the jungle. So Mother and Father created prison planets for our rehabilitation, to educate us so that we can become self-regulating, self-peaceful, self-safe, but once the corporations were set up, Mother Nature and Father Cause also allowed the corporations to abuse us. And when they started abusing their power over us, it diminished, like it says here, it diminished or destroyed our value. And the value that is we're referring to here is the value that's connected to the corporate birth certificate application bond, which is that bond is backed by our labor. So the bond's value is backed by our labor. So if the corporation is let's just put it that way, here's the tone of the word, and the corporation created a public policy called HGR 192, which opened up a door for the people to recover our natural sovereign inherited value, where all the resources on the earth are to be shared equally and distributed equally amongst all of us. And there's separate classes on learning how to do that. But if I was giving a live presentation or a webinar, if anyone had questions on that, they could raise up their hand, just like Winston Trout would do in his live seminars, and he would answer particular questions right there on the spot, until some of the people raised up their hands and complained that there were too many questions. So it seemed like a good process that Winston had outlined there to show us how to present seminars live in the classroom in a building, a physical building, which and then he'd write on the chalkboard any questions that he would want to cover later. He'd just put them up in the corner. So, let's look at this one. Okay. So here's what I was looking for. As you can see, indulge led to the next word that I wanted to look, which was grandiose. And you can see there's grandiose, narcissistic, and egocentric regressed. And you can see down here in my Finder window, I have those words right here. Narcissism, egocentricism, and emotions repressed, I did for that one. So I created my own words for that record. So as you can see, going through all these, separate web page led to a new word. And so I put all the words in as the order you can see all the words that I've made. There's template, stencil, pigment, color, visual perception, property, incorporeal, corporation, real property, subset of land, possessory, and then finally sovereignty. And by the time I got down to sovereignty, I was a little bit burnt out. and that would be the indulgence that my astrological chart was showing me. And somehow that's tied in to this, to the whole subject that we started on, which was spoiled. And I tied it all into commerce and how Mother Nature has used the corporation to cause us to be spoiled. And remember, spoiled, when we look at it, open up the window. Here we go. As you can see, this one, this is the one that I centered on, which was parents shielding the child from normal everyday frustrations. So that has to do with going back into shadow work. And I was noticing that when we're not allowed to, as children, to express ourselves, thus the note that I put down here, shielded from expression. There's the mental note that I put on the digital format here in the Finder window. As you can see, the title up there says Shielded from Frustration, but then this one is Shielded from Expressions. In other words, the parent did not know enough to encourage us to express our feelings, whether they be feelings of depression or feelings of happiness. And let's just look at this one here. Those are just my own ideas, so they were just mental notes. To destroy the value of, okay, shield from expression, shielded from frustration. Okay, I just wanted to go back to that. So as you can see, the whole thing, I mapped out and put my own definitions on my reality. And that was the whole idea when I launched my Polaris missile, was to defeat the feeling of depression. And it worked. It worked as soon as I, right off the bat, I looked at the definition spoiled. And then it just built stronger and stronger and stronger as I went from one word, one web page leading to another. And these are all from the Wikipedia website. And I mapped out a whole course to steer our emotions toward so that we can feel good. But I'll go through the rest of these in another video when the time's ready. But for now, I just wanted to share that so that if you're feeling depressed, or if things happen in our life, anything that happens in our life, if we have feelings of depression that all of a sudden want to take us down, then we have a process to bring us into balance. So, a little swolfin, yeah, I have my balance. Little swoop had just decided to visit. I is. A little swoop had. He called me. I'm here, Will. I'm here, Will. So, alright, well, we'll end this video.